الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد.
استووا أقيموا صفوفكم واعتدلوا استووا أقيموا صفوفكم واعتدلوا استووا أقيموا صفوفكم واعتدلوا.
Should find present what it has done of good and what it has done of evil. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah said, it is your action that I will count and I will reward you accordingly. Whoever did well, then he should thank Allah. And whoever did other than that, then he should only blame himself. Whoever did not do well in this Ramadan, then he should not lose hope. Because the gate of repentance is always open. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us our shortcomings within this month and to help us to repent before it is too late.
Amen.
This blessed month of Ramadan was a time when the righteous were competing against each other to who could do the most good deeds. But some of us, once the month has passed, they go back to their sins and their old ways. Such people are those who only know Allah during Ramadan or during a calamity. These people have not understood truly what Ramadan is about. But others, the righteous ones, feel sadness when Ramadan has finished and cannot wait for the next Ramadan. This is because they understood the true importance of this month and the huge benefits contained within it and how much they are in need of their Lord. Be honest, by Allah, in which group are you? By Allah, are these two groups equal? As Allah says, shall we treat those who believe and do good the same as the mischief makers on the earth? Or shall we make those who guard against evil like the wicked? I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we be from those whom the fasting has increased their iman and they have benefited from the night prayer. The Salaf rahmatullahi alayhim would feel sad whenever Ramadan left them. They would feel worried their deeds had not been accepted. Just as Allah described them, and those who give what they give while their hearts are full of fear. What is the need of the Muslim is to keep going after Ramadan and not to stop just because the month is gone. Allah says, continue then in the right way as you are commanded. And also he who has turned to Allah with you. There is no day off from worshipping Allah. It was asked to Imam Ahmed, rahimahullah, when should we rest? He replied by saying, once you step your foot inside of Jannah. There is no day off from worshipping Allah. O you who have repented to Allah in Ramadan from drinking alcohol, don't go back. You who have proved yourself you can do it, why go back? Likewise, those who smoke, you have tried to stop for a whole month and you managed it. So don't go back. Why go back to Ramadan? Servant of Allah, even if Ramadan has finished, the prayer and dua have not. We have in front of us five prayers every day that we should look after. Allah said, strictly guide the prayers.